My name is Walter Kay. I'm the founder and executive director of the Eating Disorder Program. It's been puzzling for a long time how people with anorexia are able to not eat very much and lose a large amount of weight. One of the things that has been found in animals and humans that don't have an eating disorder is that when you get hungry, there are parts of the brain that are very powerful for motivating eating and they become more active. And so we really want to ask the question, is that what's, you know, is there some difference in that circuit? We've known for a long time that people with anorexia tend to have a different kind of interaction with food. In fact, food or thinking about food makes them uncomfortable and anxious, and not eating may reduce some of that anxiety or even feel kind of empowering. What we found in the healthy control women was just really what we expected, that on the day that they were hungry versus the day they were full, the circuit that motivates us to eat became more active. Just not surprising. But what was interesting and very different about people with anorexia is on the day they were hungry, that circuit did not become more active. This suggests to us that there's something different about the signal to eat in people with anorexia, that hunger just isn't driving an intuitive drive to eat and approach food. And that really explains why people with anorexia can starve themselves or lose so much weight. The second thing that we found is that in another part of the same circuit, the more anxious and inhibited people with anorexia were, the more it blocked the signal through this pathway, suggesting that we're starting to understand something about this relationship between anxiety and not eating in people with anorexia. The frustrating thing about treating anorexia is we've not had powerful treatments to really help them eat and gain weight. We're now looking at psychological treatments to help people motivate and eat even if they don't have a drive to do that, as well as even some medications which may act on the neurotransmitter in the system that we think may be involved and is interfering with eating. This can be a chronic disorder lasting many years. And people even die from anorexia, and it's the highest death rate of any psychiatric illness. We're hopeful that we can turn this finding into a more effective treatment for this very deadly and chronic disorder.